I'll go ahead. I want to do it.
Why?
What?
Well,
there is only one way to celebrate.
Great morning so far.
Mark, this is the sort of entertainment you'd come up for. Is it one of your hotels?
I think this could be a good game, actually. See, you could burst the most bubbles in the shortest amount of time. Unbelievable.
Whenever I do it, though, I always wonder where the airs come from.
Yeah. I just never know when to stop. You just want to keep going.
Well, where's this made?
What are you breathing in?
Yeah, where's it come? What is it? You know, you might be releasing dark matter, Simon.
And can you write it? Can you make it?
I'm not saying you overthink every single situation that we do in the show, Tim, but...
But where has the air come from?
Why do you want to go back to it?
They've trapped air from somewhere in the world and they've brought it over to...
Here's your challenge this morning out there.
They've now brought their air to Britain. We don't know what's in that air.
Oh, it is. So
right. Okay.
Tonight, I'm talking about that later and tasting some whiskey. Anyone into Burns Night Scotland celebrating?
I like whiskey.
Yeah. You're in the right place.
Haggis, anyone like that? I love a bit
love
of haggis.
I
served haggis the other week in the programme.
Did you like it?
I did a special Scottish night.
Did you also do deep fried Mars bar as well?
Yes.
Isn't that slightly insulting?
Yeah, some of the people in Scotland weren't over impressed with that.
Oh, I wonder why.
But it's no different than if I'd have done sort of a Cockney or London night and served jellied eels. That doesn't mean that everybody in London eats jellied eels.
Yeah, all right. Okay, well, I understand that. Gaz, you're apparently a Broadchurch fan, aren't you? So we've got the shifty...
indoors, or have you got him training?
Do you know what? He's getting very good at that, actually.
Good for you.
Down to my wife, maybe, down more than to me, because I'm not there enough. But he does sulk if I leave now.
Really?
He gets a bit upset, yeah.
It's but horrible. I love him. I hate leaving him.
I love my dog.
Mark, have you got a dog?
No, but I live on a farm, so I've got sort of about 50 sheep that come and welcome me when I come home. It's quite bizarre.
Nice.
They're not my sheep, but it's quite useful. But I get that welcome. It's, you know, sort of 50 of them come running up to the fence to see me, you know?
I think they probably want to be fed, don't they, or something?
Sorry?
They probably want to be fed.
Yeah, I think that's what it is. Yeah. They're not actually interested in me. They're just hungry.
Right, OK. What am I doing with this?
Right, so, what we do? So...
OK, as you can see, that's tomorrow 9 here on Channel 4. Now, we're here with the star of Channel 4's The Hotel, Mark Jenkins. We're back for the third series on The Hotel, one of our favourites on the show. We do love it. For anyone who doesn't watch it, can you explain what it is and how it came about?
It's a bit like having Big Brother in a hotel, really, I suppose, in a way, because all the cameras are sort of, you know, sort of fixed cameras, so you don't see any camera crew, so everybody ends up forgetting that the cameras are there. So, you know, you get to see real reality.
How did it come about in the first place, then? Was it someone, a producer, stayed in your hotel and thought,
Yeah, no, 4 years ago, I just had a random phone call from the local tourist board asking if I'd like to take part. That was when I owned the hotel and that, and it sort of started from there.
Because originally, there was more than one hotel featured, wasn't there?
Yeah, well, the hotel series, the very first series featured a hotel in the Lake District, the Dams and Dean. And then sort of they came and found me, and then I think I sort of confused it a little bit, and they've just sort of stuck with me, really. So now, even though I haven't got a hotel, they're still filming me in a hotel. I did. I sort of gatecrashed this hotel for the summer. No, that's not true. I mean, the hotel that for this series is, you know, they're sort of typical of sort of a larger, old sort of family-owned hotel that hasn't got the money for investment. Do you know what I mean? So they need to do something to give them an umph and sort of give them the edge. So I was there to give them an umph. That's what I was there for.
Are you the right man for the job, Mark?
Oh, definitely. Yes. I gave them lots of umph.
Because you're in as ent manager, so you're running all of the entertainment in the hotel. What kind of things have you brought to the hotel?
Well, it wasn't just about entertainment in the hotel. It was about drawing attention to the hotel. So, you know, so far we've sort of did a world record attempt to create the biggest scone. It didn't actually end up being a world record. It sort of went down from sort of world to Great Britain to England to Devon to Torbay to Torquay to sort of, you know... But it was quite a big scone, although it wasn't round and it was like a Big Mac, it was sort of three levels. But anyway, so when they first tipped it out of the pan, it looked more like a flat, giant flapjack, I must admit. It went a bit wrong. But we got away with it, and I sold it at £2 a little sample to hundreds of people that came to have a look at it. So we made money out of it. So, no, things like sort of giant scones. I put on Scottish Night, special Scottish Night, which was, the idea behind that was to keep the Scottish guests in the hotel and not go out to the theatre on a Wednesday night. Unfortunately, they all went anyway, so we didn't have any Scottish people on the Scottish Night, but, you know, but it was still full. We've got, I mean, there's still a few other sort of bits and pieces sort of coming up in the programme. I don't want to spoil it, you know, what's happening, but no, it was great fun.
Well, we've got a clip. This is, I assume this is something coming up in, is this coming up in the later, in the next?
It is tonight.
This is tonight. Right. Here we go.
Do you have like a crown thing, like a Mr. Gay Torbay or a Miss Gay Torbay or something like that? I think people like competitions. Just wondered if maybe we could help organise a Mr. and Mrs. Gay or something. I'm not sure, you know, just as an extra little title. We could even get them a little cup or something. And a certificate.
I don't think they're buying in.
Actually, the Mr. Torgay contest was really good. Although it doesn't go quite as planned tonight. I must admit, it wasn't... the hotel hosted the Riviera Pride sort of weekend, and it didn't go quite to plan. I tried to get sort of a big-name personality sort of down as well, and I got sort of... Alison sort of onto that, and you know, she's phoning up sort of, you know, Gary Barlow, One Direction, people like that. But we did in the end, we did get some.
Do you not reveal it? Is it on tonight? Do you want to keep it? You want to hold it back?
Reveal it.
We got, he was late though, he was very late because he was doing something else. So by the time and there was nobody there, it was all a bit of a disaster, but you'll see tonight. What's he called? The cage fighter.
Alex Reed.
Yes, because we said whoever came, we would name a suite after them, and we do. We get the Alex Reed suite. See, Gary Barlow and One Direction, they missed out.
Gary watches somebody sitting at home going, "Why didn't my agent tell me about that?" You started in the business age 7, didn't you? Didn't you start performing in your dad's hotel?
Yes, yeah, I used to, my father...
Is that you?
Yes, that's me.
Wow.
Oh, goodness, yeah. I've still got the jacket and trousers at home somewhere. What used to happen is my father was always sort of on the stage. He was an entertainer for most of his life. And he initially started off sort of when he was sort of young, out on the streets busking. So, you know, sort of father-like son sort of thing. When I was 4, he taught me to sing a few songs and literally sent me out with my elder sister busking for money on the streets.
Stroke begging.
Well, no, that's not begging. If you're on the streets and you have a talent, then that's busking.
Yeah. All right.
Actually, you're probably right. I was begging. So by the time I got sort of 6 or 7, my father had sort of retired from the show business and they decided to sort of move to Torquay and buy a hotel. So it meant I didn't have to go on the streets busking anymore. It's brilliant. I could do my little sort of act to the hotel guests. And that's what I used to do. So on a sort of Thursday or Friday night, I used to gather all the guests into the hotel lounge, do my little act, which was, you know, a bit of singing and sort of, you know, a few impressions and a few sort of stand-up gags. And then I'd pass the hat round for me money.
Begging.
It's not begging. It's a
begging. You know. Generally, when you go to watch someone entertain, you pay before.
Yeah, but that way round, I think it's much fairer. You just pay for what it was worth.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I think that's a better way.
That's the way it should work.
Yeah, yes.
Bands. Not empty hats, whether.
When Gaz is doing his gig, he should do the songs, then go, right, I'm going around on a hat now, and then pay me more. What do you think? All right, brilliant.
As ever, we could talk to you all day. Brilliant, great. Thank you. And you can see the Hotel tonight.